It's summer 2022, COVID doesn't seem to be going anywhere and it seems like it's gotten used to us just as we've gotten used to it, and as for the war taking place in Ukraine, there doesn't seem to be any light at the end of the tunnel. In this context, it seems more and more obvious that the global economy has no way of doing well and we are hearing the word inflation more often than before. But what is this inflation? And why did everyone start talking about it? If we look at the exact definition of inflation, inflation refers to a general increase in the prices of goods and services in the economy over time that corresponds with a decrease in the value of money. Basically, with same amount of money you will afford less, meaning your purchasing power will decrease. If you hear that this year the inflation rate is 2%, it does not mean that every good or service price has increased with this value, it means that the average increase in price for goods and services is 2%, comparing to the same period of the previous year. For example, if you take the average weighted cost of a basket of goods this year, and divide it by the cost of same basket from the previous year, you'll probably get a result similar to the inflation rate since the goods in your basket are the final product of different industries. As you can see, since 2014 until 2020, the inflation in US oscillated around the value of 2%, which is actually a good thing, since the purpose of a small inflation rate has the role to prevent deflation. Deflation is the exact opposite of inflation, meaning that prices are going down and people gain more purchasing power, which at a first glance seems very good, but it's not. Let's take an example. You want to buy a bottle of water, it's cheaper than it was a year ago, but you'll not buy more water just because it's cheaper now. The factory producing this bottle of water will be in the end paid less for its product, meaning their income will decrease, and in the end they will have to fire people or even close the factory. So the economy will have more to suffer in this case. That's why deflation is even worse than inflation. Normally an inflation rate between 0 and 2% is considered to be the optimal level. The reason everyone is talking about inflation now is that it has reached a level it hasn't reached since 1990. This increase has been attributed primarily to supply shortages, including chip shortages and energy shortages caused by the COVID-19 pandemic and the Russian invasion of Ukraine, coupled with strong consumer demand. During the COVID-19 crisis, many countries opted to print money in order to save the economy. More money printed inevitably resulted in higher prices and implicitly to higher inflation. Before the invasion, Ukraine accounted for 11.5% of the world's wheat crop market, and contributed 17% of the world's corn crop export market, and the invasion caused wheat and corn from Ukraine unable to reach international market, causing shortage, and result in dramatic rise in prices. Additionally, the price of Brent crude oil per barrel rose from $97.93 on February 25 to a high of $127.98 on March 8. This caused petrochemicals and other goods reliant on crude oil to rise in price as well. All over the world, we see now central banks using their most powerful weapon against inflation, the interest rate. The increase in the interest rate, what we are seeing happening now almost everywhere in the world, has the effect of lowering the rate of inflation. Basically, by increasing the interest rate, central bank reduces the money supply available to purchase risk assets. So, the money becomes more expensive with the increase in the interest rate. Too much of an increase in the interest rate can lead to a drastic slowdown in the economy. Companies not being able to borrow money just as easily, they will find it harder to continue their activity. The whole situation is an extremely delicate one, and it is a real challenge for governments all over the world to find solutions in order to stop the price increases and also the economy not to be seriously affected, which at the moment seems almost impossible. But this is our chance as humanity to demonstrate that we've learned something from events like the Great Recession and the two world wars, and that we can recover and become stronger than ever. If you enjoyed our video, please hit the like and subscribe buttons. This will help us a lot. And, as always, thank you so much for watching.